Rock Pumpkins with their hit single, My Dog Ate My Homework.
How are y'all doing tonight? Woo! Rock Pumpkins, we're ready to gore you to death.
We also hate people who have animal names for names.
It's a slippery slope.
We've got something going. We really have this creative spark and excitement all around me. So Claire and I were in the square, we were just playing hacky sack, talking about our, you know, animal names and all, and we really just got to start talking, and, you know, people started noticing what we were doing. It was really special. Okay, so what I'm thinking is this. We need to get a message out. Something that hasn't been done before.
That's it, yes. You know, how do we get them on our side?
Yeah, like how do we combine protest with a song?
Oh my god, can you guys shut the fuck up? You've been talking for 2 hours. That's the same thing. And still have not found, like, the thesis of the conversation.
Oh,
we just found it, okay? The thesis is we have to sing songs to get people's attention.
Yeah.
To save the animals.
Shit.
Well, okay, why don't we show you what we've been working on so you can kind of get a sense of this thing?
I mean, I didn't consent to this, but okay.
Okay. Sorry, do you want to listen to this song?
Yeah, I mean,
perfect, let's do it. All right. Should we do the one about the... Yeah.
That one.
Hi, my name is Kate Snake. That was the most beautiful fucking thing I heard in my life, but I wasn't going to tell them that because I didn't want their ego to get too big. So I told them this instead.
Where the fuck did you guys go? I'm gonna call
them. Oh, sorry.
Yeah, we got really warm up to that.
Yeah. So I threw on a jacket.
Everyone to walk into a building and immediately scent us.
Yes.
they
yes.
want.
Yes,
exactly.
Like a warm
yeah,
hug.
Yeah, but you can't just be a, you know, a warm, cuddly pumpkin spice latte. You gotta be a little rough, you know?
We gotta be like rough pumpkins.
Why?
Well, yeah.
I mean, oh, okay.
They met me. Pete Armadillo. The one that name not rhymes. But that's what made me special. When I saw them in the park and I was like, one, I need money. Two, they need to round it out because three's an unlucky number. I made that up. I don't know. It could be fine, but I consider it unlucky. At least that's what I told them. And that's when I met them, and I just thought, yeah, we need to be a band.
Right.
I was just sitting over there, and I thought, this is good.
What's your name, stranger?
Pete Armadillo.
Oh, okay.
You're like that guy from, like, Shining Time Station or whatever.
Now that's a 90s reference.
Yes.
It's true.
Yeah.
Oh, no, you mean my family was too poor for trains?
Oh,
you could only walk.
I mean, your hat is kind of misleading because you do look like someone on the train tracks.
Yeah, he's got style.
That's true.
He's got style.
He's got that, like,
bring style to this
he's
man.
He's got that, like, stylish orphan thing going on.
And
you
do? Track?
Clark was just going to show us his guitar.
Yeah, fine, whatever.
Okay.
Well, what's your song called?
I wrote this song when I was just a little kid. It's called Hit It.
I'm very creative.
Well, hit it.
But I wanted to be that, you know, ear friend, so I talked to him to kind of get his and sell the, you know, music.
Yeah, so at the end of the day, I'm the one that accidentally killed my parents.
Oh, no. Buddy, look.
I was just trying to get my driver's license.
Look. Yes, and your parents were clearly saying, stop driving, we're right here.
We had just moved to America and I was used to the other
side. Oh, you were still used to the other
side? They taught me to drive there, we moved here, that's where I took my driving test.
Okay, well, how do you drive now?
Very badly.
Well, look, Pete, this music thing is really starting to take off. I feel like that we could be something, you know? Yeah, and I think that we need to get a little more positivity into your life.
No, I think, like, more sadness drives rock and roll, you know what I mean?
Look, it's funny that your name is Pete Armadillo, because I'm just looking at a shell of a person.
Sorry. You're right.
Look, I get it. Clark Sharp, people think I'm gonna, you know, bite you or drink your blood or something. I don't know.
Nah, I just think you're gonna sell me like a used car.
Yeah, that's true. But I am no shark like that. It's just a cool family given name.
So what's up with like you and Claire there?
Oh, Claire.
You don't see it. She looks at you with eyes like, well, I wouldn't know. I'm not really happy anybody that loves me, but. If someone did, I would think they'd look at me like that.
Well, I mean, look.
How do you feel?
I like Claire, don't get me wrong, but I... Look, we've started...
Like her, or do you like her?
You really want the honest truth?
Yeah.
I only know one way to give an honest truth.
You're gonna sing
like that. I am gonna sing.
I'll make back you up.
Please.
If you could say something to her right now, what would you say?
By the way, everyone at Starbucks, we're gonna do a little open mic for you.
I'm just waiting for my latte.
Okay.
Yeah, well, you're in a concert now, aren't you? Sit down. I will kill you.
Okay.
Sit down and listen.
He's trying to learn love. This is his way of affection. I'm sorry.
I have a car outside, I will back over you.
You leave one media packet behind you. Thank you.
Here you go. Oh, I'm not good at throwing either. That was pretty good. Anyways, look, if I could tell Claire anything, I would tell her this. I would tell her that you mean a lot to me. We've built something from nothing. And I think that we gotta cross something else. But
yeah, I think you need to work on your song titles, man.
Yeah!
Starbucks, we're closing in 5 minutes. If you're gonna sing a song, just fucking sing.
You are staying open!
Well, I do have a song I wrote called Hair in the Mouth.
Yeah, that's romantic.
Yeah, it is actually. Alright.
Oh yeah, it's gonna get dirty.
Taste something is a lavender, couldn't be something.
being
one more thing out. You're going home, I promise.
Yeah, here's $20.
Look, Claire. Claire, ever since we met on the square, the air around you is just magnetic. And I feel there's this pull towards us, but I was afraid to say something because every time a man has a relationship in it, that is almost 99% of the reason why it ends.
But guys, this is so good for the band's image. We are getting so many likes.
Is this live?
This is live.
Yeah.
I love streaming
this.
Yeah, live streaming.
Okay, I'm going to try not to think about being perceived. Clark. I've been afraid to tell you, but I think I feel the same way. It's just so hard because the message has to be number one for me.
Yeah.
You know, the mission has to come first.
Yes.
And I was afraid too. I was afraid that we wouldn't succeed as a band or as advocates, but maybe we can.
We can now. Let's do this. Let's take the risk.
I was totally going to market off of their relationship and then take the money, break up the band, and move to Rio. Organization, so I had to kind of step in as the de facto manager.
You
know,
I helped a bit, and we capitalized on merchandising. That's right, we created all sorts of Claire and Clark merchandise.
Claire and Claire plus Clark forever with number four.
Little dolls that can make a kiss. Rolls of toilet paper where one square was one space and the next square was the other space. That was ill thought out, but it sold really well.
It was a great idea, Pete. You did good. You can sit down, Pete. He's a good egg. He does well. And now he's coming to Rio too. But yeah, so we had our first gig, and Claire needed a little bit of encouragement.
I don't know if I can do this. This is the biggest audience we've ever had.
Claire, look at me. Just don't even think of it as an audience. Just think of it as a murder of crows.
Yeah.
Or a pile of puppies. Just think of the animals.
A pot of whales.
A
powder of cats.
Yes. Claire is a litter of cats.
A clowder of cats.
Okay, we'll go with it.
Yeah, a flagrancy of peacocks.
Yes.
Okay. All right. All right. This is the biggest Starbucks in Seattle, and we have a huge audience. Hey, really quickly, are you all salary? Or are you all, hourly?
I'm writing a screenplay.
hourly. Okay.
I just want to feed my kids.
Okay, we get it. We're doing it. Okay.
You think because we're sort of the hub of everything, and Seattle being what it is.
Aren't you the stevia guy?
Yes, I'm the stevia guy.
He's our biggest fan. He's been following
us. I'm having a cover boss situation. All right.
Oh.
All right, let's do it.
Okay,
we're going
to sing the song. All the bunches of animals.
Okay.
You got this.
I'll just be in the back.
Woo-hoo! Oh my God, there's just a sea of people holding.
Famous, and the money was rolling in. For years, we just toured and toured every Starbucks in the country and in the world. We did an all Starbucks tour. It took 20 years to do it. That's a lot of Starbucks around. But things kind of got ugly. Claire and Clark's relationship got too in the way, and I was sick of standing in the back. So when we were in Brazil, in Rio, finally, everything got a little ugly.
Our authentic Brazilian garb, guys.
It suits you, Kate. It suits you.
Pete, you look kind of down in the dumps.
I'm getting kind of sick of not being acknowledged or even listened to.
Oh my God, here we go again.
Hey, what do you mean here we go? Let him talk.
I'm sorry. It's just, you know, Pete can get a little tiring with his emotional rantings.
Listen, guys, we need Pete. You know, yes, you're the celebrity couple, the John and Kate, and we're the plus eight.
It's a really good analogy. It's a really good analogy.
Solid.
Four in one, four in the other. It evenly splits.
It makes it much harder for me to say that. Well, I'll just use the metaphor. We're breaking up. We're getting divorced.
Whoa!
Well, that is not convenient.
Children. I was going to wait until Brazil, but I just can't deal with it.
We're in Brazil.
I was going to wait until after.
We can't leave Brazil.
What?
What do you mean we can't leave Brazil?
What
did you do, Kate?
So, you know, we were making a lot of money, and I needed to kind of put it somewhere.
Kate.
So, you know, it's kind of, you know, stuck here.
In Brazil or in your body?
How the fuck did he know? I was gonna smuggle all the cash out of Brazil and bring it to Argentina. Because I never expected them to tour Brazil. That was going to be where I escaped. With Pete, of course. See, the whole plan was to make it look like Pete was chopped liver, but Pete, me and him we've been sitting in the park for years. This was our moment. And we were just gonna milk this relationship. But I wasn't ready for this yet. We had to keep them together.
Look,
let's not mind what's in my body right now. It's just what's important is you guys.
You two are the force, the romantic force that keeps this group together.
Yeah.
Well, romantic farce.
Sorry.
You know we have been having issues.
Yeah, but
you know it.
Where Clark's song came from, Romantic Farce. It was the saddest song I ever heard. He kind of went emo with that one.
Hey, how are we all doing? Good?
Hola. Oh, wait. I don't speak Portuguese.
She's Portuguese, yeah. But what does it freaking matter anyway?
You! Joy!
what?
Drink your water.
Yeah, I was really dehydrated on that one. Yeah.
Even Starbucks is in Brazil. You gotta buy something.
Yeah, I brought this Ethos water.
Yeah, man.
You know, Ethos, the only time I've ever seen it is at Starbucks. You know what?
All right, everybody. All right, I know tempers are hot right now. Everyone's
it's the Stevia guy.
Shut the fuck up, Stevia guy.
I am the sponsor of your tour ever since Poughkeepsie all the way to Seattle. I have stayed with you guys.
Listen,
oh.
I'm sorry.
No, I've ruined it not only for me, but I'm ruining it for everyone. No. Listen, Claire.
It's okay. Just wash it off.
Claire. If you want out, I respect your decision, and I don't want to bring you any of you down.
Turn my back for one moment and we're breaking up.
So, adios. You're my murder of crows, always.
I feel like this is the part where I'm supposed to run after him.
But
go ahead. No, but I already served him the divorce papers. I'm sorry, guys. I lost sight of what this was all about.
This is all about you.
And
they're profiting off of you.
I'm taking my egg, and I'm going. I'm going off on a solo career. Yeah, me and my egg.
Solo careers. Well, we all tried different genres, of course. Kate Snake, ever the capitalist, she got out there first and... she did songs that defied genre. Some could say that it was just words. Really lyric-heavy, just words. And of course, who could forget that famous song with the words? My toes curl when I'm with you.
Hi, welcome to Chili's. I didn't even know they had Chili's in Argentina.
Yeah.
Most authentic Chili's. Anyway, I'm gonna sing a lot of words. How my toes curl up when I think about you. And sometimes my toenails fall off because I don't have enough vitamin D in my body. And I'm just gonna sing about stream of consciousness. Look at that guy right there. I wonder where he's from. I bet Chile. Hola. And what people don't know is that I still have some pesos in my ass. It's kind of a terrible condition. I had a colonoscopy and it didn't really work out.
Wow, this really defies genre.
Looking around at all you beautiful people just makes me think about what I did for the last 20 years of my life. I only know how to say a few things in Spanish. I can talk to animals in Spanish and go, oh, perrito lindo. 2 hours, so this could be a long night, folks. Chips and Walker included with your meals.
Oh God, I've been to Hamilton.
Look around, look around. History is humming in Manhattan. Wow, I'm really glad when I get to use my musical theater BFA.
Yeah.
one really knew what techno country was. But eventually, after all of our various picadillos, all of our failed solo careers, we actually ran into each other again. In a Starbucks, of all places. There we were back at the beginning, and we knew. I think this is it, guys. I think Rough Pumpkins has to ride at least one more time again. So, thank you all for coming here to our little reunion tour.
Woo!
This is a check for $1.5 million for you to split with them, and you keep nothing.
I'm not gonna do that. What the fuck? I've been making $8.25 for 20 years.
You still
have four children. I could not afford a company $5.29 plan. And you're gonna make $8.25 for the next 60 years.
Anyway, the de facto manager of this defunct group, we're gonna take some audience questions.
Yeah. It's been a while since we've been together in a room with our fans, or as we used to call you, a bunch of animals.
Yeah.
Fucking stinking dirty animals.
That was our iteration the first time. We softened a little bit.
Yeah.
The only question is, we bring a house light.
Can we get a question? Anybody?
Yes, in the front.
Where are the pesos?
Where are the pesos?
Well, I had a colon resection, and eventually I was able to get them removed, but I had to give it all to Stevia guy, because it was the only way I was going to get out of Chile and get out of jail, so I had to do nothing.
You've gone out of several countries. Through. How many body parts are you missing now?
Right. I'm officially grossed out. All right, so
another question.
My question is to Claire and Clark. Are you currently in relationships?
Wow.
We deserve an answer.
Our PR manager told us to prepare for this one. And
yeah,
I
they did. Claire and I have actually been talking again. Let me just clarify. Trying to build back the friendship and relationship we had, and
let me just clarify. Claire and Clark jokes.
Ron, I really wish I could.
We're reconciling. Pete, this is about you too.
This is about you.
Because we realize now that what we got wrong the first time is that we were focused on this, but we weren't focused on
this.
On this.
Even me?
Yeah, you
well,
did.
Can I tell them?
Go ahead.
Well, so Clark and Claire have adopted me as their child. After all these years, I'd like to sing Orphan No More.
Yeah.
If you can. When you run over the heavens, and they've gone up to the sky. So lonely that you also wanna die. So don't really do that. You just sit and cry. you got us.
Just open your heart.
Open it like the front door. And shove those feelings of loneliness out your back door.
Guys, like you're, you know, grifter lesbian aunt, which is why I wrote a song about it.
You did. You wrote it.
Grifter lesbian aunt.
Grifter lesbian aunt.
Go for it, Kate.
Chose you and you chose me.
I did, yeah, that's exactly right. Now
we're each other's found family.
Exactly. Found family.
No, but I got a piece of paper that's legally bought.
You
found
each other,
never made it legally bought.
You did make it legally bought.
I paid a lot for that lawyer.
He's part of our family too, because he's been there since the beginning.
We invest in families here at Star.
Okay, so.
They reopened Clark Park.
Yeah.
And the animals are all allowed back.
Yes.
I'll tell you what. Even
the armadillos.
And the bears and the sharks.
The snakes.
And the snakes.
So the animals are back.
The animals.
But I'll tell you where the after party is.
Where is the after party?
It's life. The after party's life.
The after
party's
life.
Life. Okay. Actually, that's the title of our final song.
Final single.
Last song on tour.
Yeah, last song is life.
Last song we'll ever do.